Hello everybody, this is Dimitrios again, my new video, my new haircut, and today we're gonna talk about common guitar playing myths. You know, every so often I get a new student and he definitely refers to one of them. Some of them are actually true, some of them are not, some are partially true. So we're gonna talk about those quite common to the guitar world. So, guitar playing myth number one. Guitar playing myth number one. My hands are too small, so I can't play the guitar. This is a very common one. Now, yes, some of you, your hands are small. Some of you, your hands are large. Some of you, it's really not that big of a deal. Please take a look of guitarists like Segovia. Right? He has sausage fingers. His fingers are this fat. It's unbelievable, and he plays so delicately, so beautifully. Right? There are some limitations. If you have really small hands, there are some limitations. If you want to do crazy stretches, yes, you might not be able to do it. But those stretches are quite unnecessary. It's really only 1% of the time that they are needed. Even then, there are workarounds. So, really, not a big deal. Your hands, believe me, it's definitely not an issue. Definitely not an issue. If that's holding you back, not an issue at all. Just don't even think about it. Great? Now, let's move to myth number two. So, myth number two. I can learn everything from YouTube. No. I'm sorry. No, you cannot learn everything from YouTube. Not from this channel, my channel, not from any channel. Now, why? Why is that? There is a huge difference when you're having a tutor right there to fix your mistakes, to see what you are doing in person, to see how you are putting your hands on the fretboard, what is your structure, what is your where do you tense, what really goes on, right? It's yes, you can find a lot of knowledge through YouTube. A problem is that some of them, that knowledge is either insufficient or just incorrect. Not all of the knowledge, there are very common stuff that everybody teaches here on YouTube, right? It's very common. So everybody knows them. Yeah, you can learn those, but no, you cannot take everything from YouTube. No, it's a good tool if you know how to use it. It's an even better tool if you have some real guidance from a tutor. It's an amazing tool from a guy that knows what he is talking about and what you need for your personal growth, not in general, right? For your personal growth. So, yes, then YouTube can be really amazing. That brings us to guitar myth number 3. Guitar myth number 3. I can be a self-taught musician. Take this from a guy who is a self-taught musician for the most part. You can do it, of course. Everybody can do anything if he sets his mind on. But it took me 6 months to do that by record. I can teach that to a student and he is nailing it in a week. That's the big difference. That yes, you can be self-taught, but be prepared to learn all the things the hard way. The hard way meaning go out there searching and searching and searching, taking mistakes with the good stuff, not know to differentiate between them. You know, yes, you will learn, but it's gonna take you 10 years to reach the level, this level, while with a teacher it's gonna take you 2 years to reach the same level. And that's the God honest truth. But there are some good that comes from being a self-taught. You are learning things, especially if you're playing bands and stuff. If you want to form a band and, you know, play and learn at the same time, you're learning the things the street way, right? Not the academic way. And the academic way, sometimes it can be really confusing, especially at the start. So yes, there are some pluses, but the minuses are more, actually. And take it from a guy that is mostly self-taught. That brings us to the guitar playing myth number 4. Guitar myth number 4. I don't need expensive gear to play the guitar. Yes, indeed. You can just start playing the guitar with a guitar and nothing else. Or you can take a cheap guitar with like 60 pounds or 100 pounds and you'll be perfectly fine. But this is an expensive sport, right? You're gonna pay a lot of money for gear and you're gonna want it and you're gonna pay for it and you're gonna try get money to get new gear every time. And you know, yeah, we don't need a lot of stuff, right, in life and in general also, but we like to have new toys, we like to have, and as I said, this is an expensive sport, you know, you're gonna pay some money for it. Now, let's move to guitar playing myth number 5. Guitar playing myth number 5. The insert name here, guitarist is a god. Every young student that I had over the years came up to me and, you know, just called out a name, you know, Satriani is a god, Vai is a god, Metallica, I don't know who, whatever, is a god. And my job as a tutor is to bring everybody back to reality. There are people that are, of course, gifted, no doubt about it, but nobody is a god. What they can do, you can do. They have two hands, they have two ears, a brain, you know, everything that you have, they also have it. And if you're gonna practice and go at it, you're gonna reach the same results. Bach said this, the famous Bach, the pianist, classical pianist, said this to his student every day, that whatever I can do, you can do. So the only secret is go at it, practice every day, stay focused, stay on the goal, remember what you want to do. And don't godify anyone. Don't. Because you're gonna feel like you've been cheated when one day you're gonna be able to play and to do what they do. So no, love everybody for what they have to offer to music. Right, everybody has something to offer to this beautiful thing that we call music and guitar. Everybody. So love yourself for what you're giving to your music, and also love everybody else for what they are giving to the music. And in the long run, it's gonna make you happier than just being a fanboy of somebody and, you know, just praising somebody or etc. etc. So yeah, just love. That brings me to guitar playing myth number 6. So guitar myth number 6. I don't need to be able to read music. Well, you know that music is a language, right? You know that we are communicating with music. Like when you are speaking, can you imagine that if you couldn't write anything down on a piece of paper? Can you imagine that? How much disabling that would be? And also, can you really miss out the opportunity to be able to read someone else's thoughts and someone else's, you know, work that he was so hard putting down on paper, that he tried so hard to put down on paper? So yeah, I believe that music reading is essential. You might not need to, you know, to be the sight reader that takes, you know, a part and reads it on the fly. Like, no, nothing like this. But yes, you definitely want to not miss the opportunity to be able to read the score and understand, and you know, it's gonna open so much potential for you, so much potential. And again, not crazy stuff. I'm not an avid music reader myself. I don't find the necessity to go down sight read everything, and I really don't. I never needed it, even as a session musician. I never needed to read, because you know, most of the time somebody is gonna come with a part, you're gonna hear it and you're gonna transcribe it mostly by ear rather than anything else. And yeah, but music reading opens a whole new world that you don't want to miss out. And it's really not that hard. You know, it seems like it's hard, but it's really not that hard to learn the basics. I mean, nothing crazy, just the basics. So you can understand basic stuff when you're reading a chart. You don't need anything more, just the basics. That brings me to guitar playing myth number 7. Guitar playing myth number 7. So, I love the guitar. I'm going to be a rock star. All right. That's a good one. That's a good one. That's the 16th, 17 years old motto. It's nice. Yeah, it's really good to have dreams and really good to strive for them and really good, but you need to always have one foot on the real world. And the real world is that in music, there is only a small percentage of musicians that make it. And no, it's not about that the rest of the musicians is not as good or etc. etc. It's just the nature of the beast, right? There are not too many jobs that they offer you money for music, so there are too many people that play music. It's just the nature of the beast. And take a look of the thousands and thousands and millions of musicians. How many are the rock stars? It's like 20 bands, and I mean the number is, I don't think that it's more than like 2% or 3% at the most. So yeah, be real here. If you are doing that just because you want to achieve a status, you know, a status in life, just don't do it. Don't do it. Simply don't do it. If you're gonna do music, do it for the right reasons. And the right reasons is because it feels you, not some ambitions. It feels your soul. If it feels your soul, you don't need to get money out of music. You don't need to do, yeah, of course everybody needs to survive, okay? That's why I'm here also. I mean, nobody feeds out of ether or anything, but yeah, the most the basic reason that you need to do this is love. Is love for music, love for what you do. And believe me, it pays off tremendously. And you're gonna know about this if you're gonna go through a rough patch. Music is there for you. It is the most comforting thing that you can have in your life. So treat it as precious as it is. That brings me to guitar playing myth number 8. Yeah, guitar playing myth number 8. Guitar playing myth number 8 is a good one. It goes something about like this. I'm gonna grab a guitar, I'm gonna, you know, casually play in and out for, you know, and after a couple of years, I'm gonna be a great guitarist. Really? No. You might gonna learn a few chords, you're gonna have some maybe you're gonna be lucky and play, you know, the totally basic chords on guitar, but that's about it. You need to understand that music is a serious thing, right? And it calls for serious commitment. Serious commitment, it calls for serious exercise. It's like any other, you know, any other profession out there, maybe twice as demanding as any other profession out there. But yeah, no. If you are gonna go casual with it, you're gonna get what you're gonna put in. Simple as that. If you're gonna put in 5 minutes, you're gonna take 5 minutes of worth. If you're gonna put in 1 hour, you're gonna take 1 hour of work. Simple as that. Let's move on to guitar myth number 9. Guitar myth number 9 goes something like that. Who needs theory? You, me, everybody. Everybody needs theory. Why? Yeah, it's very cool when you're just grabbing a guitar and go like, but do you understand what I did there? Like I did 251, 25, 25, 25. Do you understand what I'm talking about? 2-5, 2-5, 2-1 on two different keys. Why is it essential that you do understand what I'm talking about right now? Because when I'm gonna come and play a gig with you, when I'm gonna say to you that I did 2-5-1 in C major, and you're gonna take a look at me like, we're gonna have a problem if you don't understand what I'm talking about. How am I gonna, should I invent a new language because you don't want to learn theory? Why? There is a language there, why not use it? And why should you put yourself into digging and digging and really not discovering suddenly something that it's mundane? You know, I remember myself, because I am self-taught, I remember myself finding a couple of chords and how they work. And I was like, I'm amazed with my amazing skills and knowledge and whatever. And after I opened a theory book or two, I just saw that in the first 10 pages. It was the most mundane thing that you could do as a musician. So please, learn your theory, learn the language. I'm not talking about being a crazy academic nut job. No, I'm talking about the practical stuff. I'm talking about, like, when I'm gonna tell you that we're gonna play in D minor, you know what D minor is, you know where it is, you know which chords are after that, which chords are before that, what are the chord progressions. When I'm talking about 2-5-1, you understand what I'm talking about. When I'm talking about, you know, whatever, the common stuff, the common knowledge. I'm not talking about clusters and, you know, this and that and the other, and microtonos and negative harmony and crazy stuff. Okay. Okay, leave that to the academics. Leave that to somebody who is really into it. Like, in every day, you're not gonna find someone that is going to refer to you negative harmony. It's not going to happen. I mean, yeah, there are a few guys, a few composers. I'm also looking at YouTube, that they are looking at this stuff and, you know, they are playing through it and they're doing stuff with that. But no, no, leave that for down the road. Just know the bloody thing, the basic thing, so we can have an understanding and then we're going to move on. Let's move on. Guitar playing myth number 10. I'm too old to play the guitar. Now, that's a tricky one. That's a tricky one, actually. Are you suffering from Alzheimer? Yes? No? Are you suffering from a very bad case of arthritis? Yes? No? What else should pose a problem? If there is nothing wrong with your body, if you're not really sick, and not sick in general, but in certain areas, you can play guitar even if you are 100. You can play an instrument if you are 300 years old. Of course, if you don't have any problem, right? So, yes, you can play the guitar at any age, at any level, and it's gonna be really good for you, really good for your body, really good for your soul. Now, you need, as an older player, you need to have the correct expectations. If you are expecting to be on the highest of the highest levels of guitar playing or of music playing, yeah, at your 60s, 50s or 70s, it's not going to happen. I'm sorry. It's simply not going to happen. If you want to use guitar as an instrument of pleasure, as self-fulfillment, you know, to do some, I mean, mid-level, you may reach the upper level. Who knows? Who knows? But usually the dedication and time required, it's not enough for, you know, the elderly. But that doesn't mean that you can play, you know, normal songs. That doesn't require a crazy amount of, you know, technical proficiency. Yes, you can play almost everything that is normal out there. I don't see any reason that you cannot start the guitar at a later age. No reason. On the contrary, I think that it's going to do very, it's going to give you, really, it's going to sharpen your mind. It's going to sharpen your mind. It's going to help you rather than anything else. Yeah, that's about it. These were 10 common guitar playing myths. If you have any more myths like that in your mind, please comment down below, so I can add them in a second part, maybe. If you liked this video, hit the like button. If you really liked it, share it on social media. Subscribe to my channel, follow me on social media. Everything is listed, you know, down below in the description box. And if you really like to support me, you can become a Patreon, so I can continue to do these videos and, you know, share the love.